lines myself. Oh, there's the corner separated over here.
Yeah. They got collapsed, I think, over on that side.
Okay.
Thank you. Booster 82, continue emergency. All other units downgrade your response.
Go ahead. baby.
your name first and spell it?
Kevin Hosler, H-O-S-L-E-R.
And you're chief over at Needham?
Yes, sir.
Tell me how you first found out about it. You were on a fire and then go from there.
We were clearing an automatic alarm at the high school. We got to the intersection of I-45 and 242, and we noticed a big black column of smoke. Contacted dispatch. They advised us that they were taking 911 calls on a commercial fire here at the building, and we went ahead and responded. We were on location within 2 or 3 minutes, us and the Woodlands, and when we arrived on location, there was a large commercial structure with heavy smoke and fire visible.
What part of the building did you get most of your fire in?
Most of the fire when we arrived appeared to be in the center of the building, from the center to about the north side of the building.
Okay, any idea how many alarms we're at now?
I initially took command, I called for a second alarm. I do believe that we've asked for an additional alarm after that, so I believe we're at a third alarm.
All right. Yeah, what about the danger of these tilt walls? I mean, as far as putting guys inside there?
Tilt wall construction is very dangerous. As most people don't know, the ceiling's actually what holds up the tilt wall construction. We already had separation when we arrived on location as the first arriving units. So as far as going into the building, that was pretty much rode off from the very start of this incident.
Today. Huh? Everyone? First of all, your name?
Mike Legudis.
Mike, spell your last name.
L-E-G-O-U-D-E-S.
Tell me what you had out here today.
I had a three-alarm structure fire at Garden Ridge, which began approximately 10 minutes after 12. Got representatives from at least 6 different fire departments. We also have investigators from the City of Conroe Fire Marshal's Office, from Montgomery County Fire Marshal's Office, City of Shenandoah Fire Marshal, and the ATF National Response Team will be coming out as well. All employees got out of the store and were accounted for. One went to St. Luke's ER over here with smoke inhalation. The customers, we weren't able to account for because we just don't know who was in the store. We don't have any reports that anybody is missing, however.
What about the few cars out in the parking lot? Any ideas on those yet?
No, there's at least 2 that we haven't been able to identify at this point. The rest we've been able to identify as employees' cars.
What about the intensity of the fire? I mean, not able to make a defensive attack on this thing, right? Offensive attack, just having it go on.
We did have to make a defensive attack from the get-go, just because of the size of the fire already and the possibility of wall collapse and roof collapse. It was just too dangerous to put any firefighters inside. Obviously, it had to be a fairly large fire that was quick developing to overtake the sprinkler system and grow to the size that it grew.
Any possible links to this thing between your Walmart store a couple weeks ago and the Ross store up here in Conroe?
None whatsoever.
Okay. All right.
Name, sir? Name on title, please.
My name's Tom O'Neill. I'm the district manager for Garden Ridge, including the store here at the Woodlands. This is a devastating day for us. This is one of our premier stores. We love this location. We're dedicated to rebuilding here and keeping a store in this market. We do have six other stores in the Houston area. All of them are important to the company. And we hope to be back in the Woodlands area just as soon as possible. The good news for today is that all of our associates and all of the customers were able to get out of the store with no real injuries. We did have one employee who suffered some minor smoke inhalation and is currently being treated at the hospital. My report I just got is he's doing very well, and we're so pleased with that. The associates at the store did an outstanding job of taking care of our customers and each other and making sure that no one was hurt in this huge blaze. That's basically all I have. That's all the information I have. The investigation will be ongoing. All I can say is we look forward to coming back to the Woodlands area very, very soon. Thank you very much.
Tom, what about number of employees in this store?
23.
Okay. And we're hearing that they saw the fire start in the middle of the store?
I don't know that information. They have given statements to the fire department and to investigators. I can't comment on that.
Did they tell you what it looked like inside?
I don't know. That's all I have. Thank you.